super fast with my overlay switching. Hello, welcome!
Amazing.
Game three of today, day of five games in total, and we're casting a very important game.
Yes, it's CIS against Dreamtime, and this is, you know, two of the stronger teams, so it's really important who takes this win.
Yeah.
Of course, LGD is looking amazing through the group stages, but no one, you know, expected anything different. Dreamtime, though, I've cast some of their games and even got to see some of Air's legendary Panda now. I shouldn't say legendary, I guess, but he has been the one to kind of start the Brewmaster hype, and every single region has just started playing so much Brewmaster because of him.
Yeah.
So let's see if they're actually going to get it in the game against CIS here. Yeah. On the side of Dreamtime, though, Air being amazing on Brewmaster and all, I still feel that in July is one of my favorite players in this team. He plays really, really well in most of the games that I watch.
Radiant team. It's nice to see that finally June and in July are facing each other.
Yes, exactly. June and July. It's time to show down.
Which is the best team pick.
Yeah. No respect ban actually coming out on the Brewmaster, but it's also pretty expensive hero to first pick because he is very counterable as an early pickup. If you just pick some silence heroes, Invoker does well against him. Sure, he got banned, but even Doombringer, a hero we see repeatedly in this qualifiers, is amazing as Brewmaster to just prevent that split and kill him off before he disrupts the team fight.
Yeah, quite surprised. Also, Age Depression makes it out of the banning pool. We've seen a lot of Age Depression first bans.
That's true.
And Invoker has been making it through instead of that one. So
yeah, I think this is respect from Dreamtime though, because we have seen CIS play Naga Siren over and over again, and they love to run black on Naga Siren and farm up. And we just
recently saw it. They are the only team that won from LGD, and they did that with the Naga Siren.
Exactly, and that's a big win for CIS taking down LGD in one game, who were, to that point, undefeated in the qualifiers. So Naga Siren, pretty much a respect ban. And now, of course, CIS, if they want to, they can get that Ancient Apparition that is so highly rated by most teams here. So wouldn't be surprised to see him go for something like Treant AA or even a Doom Treant type of pickup. A lot of teams, again, going back to those tanky heroes, just hard to kill. And even Wraith King is a legit pick up, to be honest, in the first phase, because I like the way LGD draft, where they kind of reveal nothing with their first two picks. It's very hidden. They often pick sneaky heroes that could be played in many ways. For example, Wraith King, who could be a carry. And they're going to go for AA Sand King, actually.
Team pick.
It's a nice combination.
Yeah, although for Dreamtime, it's now pretty easy. If they want to have a Brewmaster, they can pick it up and ban out the Doom and other counters right after. So
that's true.
It's a bit risky for CIS. It does, of course, it's a very nice combination to have the Ancient Separation and Sand King. And wow, that is probably
Radiant
the earliest Nightstalker I've seen picked up in the qualifiers. We've seen it before.
We have seen it before.
But not this early.
Yeah. Nightstalker, of course, is a hero that I actually appreciate to see a whole lot, because this hero, he doesn't let the enemy control the game. He sets the pace of the game. Sure, you need to be very controlled in how deep you dive and when you push towers and how you do it. But he is in the driver's seat, if you want to call it that, in every single game. And that's something I think is very important when you play in competitive Dota, to not let the enemy have too much control, especially against a team like CIS, where if they get control, Black is going to farm way too much, and then it's very scary to go up against a mid-late game.
10 seconds.
Yeah, a bit of pressure for the Nightstalker, I guess, to do well in night times. Hmm. We've seen Nightstalker mid, and we've seen him also on the safe lane. Which one do you prefer?
Oh, I would probably like mid so much more, because he doesn't rely so much on the gold. He relies only to get the levels. And already on minute four, when the first nighttime pops, he can start doing something then, or at least has the option to do something, because mid, you're very close to every lane. If you want to go and fight, if you get a good rune, like a Haste or DD rune, you can go and fight even harder. Meanwhile, if you're on carry position and just farming up, you can really only counter TP with the Nightstalker. That can sometimes be enough, though, but I just don't like NS as a farmer. But we will see.
Yeah, I do. Like, that first rune, or rather the 4 minute rune, is going to be so incredibly important for that Nightstalker. It's going to decide if he can roam or not.
It's really always, the 4 minute rune in general is very important, not only because of nighttime shift, but also on every single mid hero, because that's when you have some decent levels to work with. You should be level 5 or so by then, depending on what has happened in the game. But if you get a nice haste rune, DD rune at the minute 4 spawn, that's usually translates into kills really easily. Yeah, sometimes you might just get an illusion or whatever and fill your bottle, though.
Dragonite for CAS, so it looks like we're going to have that one in mid lane. Bit surprised by that, because normally when you go up against a Nightstalker and you know that you're going to be up against a Nightstalker, you want to pick a hero that can win the lane from him, or at least maybe shut him down a little bit to try and delay his activeness in night times. And Dragonite is kind of the hero that will allow any mid hero to go up against him and get levels and get farms. So it's a surprising pick for me.
Yeah, I feel the same, that when you have a Nightstalker in the enemy team, the one benefit that you get is that you can run anything you want against NS mid, pretty much. Because anyone can get away with laning against NS and pretty much shut him down. But it makes a little bit of sense when you look at it. You have AA, Sand King, Dragon Knight. And earlier in this qualifier, we have even seen Dragon Knights later on by Blink Dagger, just to blink initiate with Dragon Form. It's really instant. And with the follow-up they have from AA and Sand King, I think their mid-game fights are going to be pretty fine. And it also gives them some push that they desperately need. Because when you draft AA Sand King, you don't have any tower damage. Like, you have good kill potential, but you need to push as well.
Yeah, talking about pushing Centaur. So now you've got a full package for CIS. You've got initiation with the Centaur. Get a successful gank off with that.
There's so much
and push
disable.
Down a tower. They can easily... Like, they have a very early game fighting lineup, which I guess you have to do if you're going to be up against a Nightstalker. Mm. Wow, Dreamtime really wants to go for dark bluish.
They're going for the late game as well here, picking up a Spectre. Sure, you have a Visage and you have a Nightstalker who could potentially roam down to your lane to help it, but Visage Spectre is it's a start of a fairly weak lane, because Spectre is not that strong in her own on her own. And here, I think CIS have the option. They can even go for a tri-lane with Centaur if they want to, with Sand King and AA, to shut down that farm on Spectre. Because if you let her get the Radiance early on and rush that build, or even rush into something like Face, Drums, and then Radiance, that is very dangerous to go up against. You want to slow down the farm on the Spectre.
Radiant team. Would you like an aggressive tri-lane then? Yeah.
I would like an aggressive tri-lane, but we will see. Yeah, with Centaur or even with another hero, we will see what they pick up as the last hero. Kind of tells us what they're going to do. But you could try them with Centaur. It's not amazing to have Centaur and Sand King together, though. It could be better to just have something simple like a Mirana on this tri lane. Mirana, Sand King, AA.
Mirana, actually, I wasn't aware that she was still in the pool. Ignoring.
Yeah, this is China instead of NA qualifiers and even C qualifiers. Mirana was very high tier.
Still surprised that Brewmaster also got ignored, though.
Yeah, no attention to Brewmaster at all, but they're not going to go for it, so I'm a little bit surprised as well.
Just wow.
Okay, so they're going into Anti-Mage.
They could actually solo a safe lane Anti-Mage. Because the Darkseer is not ideal.
If you pull a lot of regen, you can.
Yeah.
But I think they might do something like... They could even just have... I don't know. I think they're going to play greedy, CIS. They're probably just going to make sure Black gets the farm. Mm-hmm. He can solo against Darkseer quite fine, but... They might go down and try an attempt on bottom lane to kill or secure some farm for Centaur in the beginning with AA Sand King, but I expect them to roam up and control their own jungle, abuse Sand King and farm up the stacks and so on.
Reserve time.
And actually protect Black, because this Anti-Mage completely solo against Darkseer is pretty hard, I feel.
Yeah, and Black, of course, I mean, Anti-Mage is one of his favorite heroes to play. So let's see if he, even though Anti-Mage hasn't been that active in the scene, if he still can play that, well, that strong carry that he always was.
He should be able to. Black is, you know, regarded as one of the best farmers in the game. And then the only thing that people would say was his weakness as a carry is that he kind of sacked his team too much and didn't really have the best decision
full
on when to go back. And it is a full blue draft from the Smurf team Dreamtime.
Yes.
So I love how Spectre looks so mad, by the way. But this draft, I don't know. Spectre is not the most amazing against Anti-Mage in the mid stage of the game. Later on, it's fine. But this game is kind of dangerous, actually, if you just trade farm against CIS, I think.
Would you expect that, say that there's a lot of pressure on that Nightstalker to do really well in the mid game?
I would say, yeah, and he definitely needs to be ready wherever the ganks are coming in. That's the biggest thing. Like, the Sand King and Centaur will probably gang a lot when AA has level 6 to just set up for that and let them come in and, like, kill with the Blink Dagger on Centaur. So at that point, Nightstalker has to be on point and get to the fights. Also Visage, I would say, because if he has the birds micro correctly and in position, that could be a nice way to counter gank against this team.
It used to be, actually, that Nightstalker was picked up as a counter to Anti-Mage.
Yeah, that's very true. Nice Stalker is fairly good against him. Anti-Mage normal timing for Manta style is going to be around minute 20, 22. And before that, he has no way to get rid of the silence, and you can just chase him down and kill him pretty easily. Even the Aghanims on Night Stalker is amazing against Anti-Mage because you can see wherever he blinks. I'm actually going to restart my Dota here as it's lagging quite
too
a fair
laggy.
Bit. Yes.
Well, I will take that time to introduce our players here as we've got In July playing the Darks here for Dreamtime. We've got ourselves Dreamy U playing the Vengeful Spirit, XDD on the Spectre, and all roaming into that dire jungle with Super on the Visage and Air playing the Night Stalker. All five heroes of Dreamtime forcing CIS out of the jungle and might be placing some wards, actually. Yes, they do. Sentry's already down. That's all to stop that Sun King from getting up his fast Blink Dagger. We're going to see a 4 CIS. It's Demons playing the Sand King with Boots first. Anti-Mage played by Black. No surprises there. And he's also supported by Io on the Ancient Apparition. Mid lane goes to Inflame on the Dragonite. And last but not least, the captain of the team, the drafter of the team, and one of the playmakers of the team
the
is June
begins.
Playing the Central War Runner on the offlane.
Yeah, I actually like to see the build, by the way, on Anti-Mage that Black goes for. That he has Salve and Double Tangle that he bought himself because he knows he's going to be up against the Darkseer and there's so much spam of Iron Shell that we really need to rely on always having the region. And finally, it seems that I'm back in the late game and no lag.
Yay.
Beautiful. Beautiful.
Beautiful. We had a lot less lag issues than yesterday, to be honest.
Oh yeah, yesterday was pretty bad, but it seems that they're just going to start off in the safe lane, by the way, with Sand King and AA. So they have a job here to just keep the Darkseer out of getting experience. If he gets level 2 and gets to level up in general, then Darkseer is hard to deal with. If he can't level up, then Anti-Mage is going to be just fine against level 1 Iron Shell. It's not that strong. And also, not having Surge, he's a potential kill for AA and Sand King.
Yeah. So far, no Surge. Went for Iron Shell level 1 just to get that harass in. Will be a bit annoying for himself because he keeps pushing the lane out, so for him to get experience will take some time. In the meantime, in the mid lane, Inflame is actually having some issues against Air here. In terms of harassment, he's getting harassed quite a bit.
Yeah, he is, and this is Nightstalker being happy as well because, as we talked about, Nightstalker is fine even in lanes where he can't get that much top there. Trying to kill in July here, not gonna dive under a tower though, very dangerous as he can salve up and gets into a tree line. Bot also coming out though, and both mid heroes are bottling up. Actually surprised to see that Inflame empty that bottle. He could have bought a run with one charge remaining, and that makes the courier a lot faster. But still fine, and this is what both mid heroes kind of rely on. But look at the courier on Radiant. It was actually out to drop a sentry to the supports on the Radiant side, so that means that the bottle is there had the gold to deliver it faster. He's now sitting at a very sad spot where he doesn't have HP and mana, and Inflame is just going to outfarm him during this time.
Yeah, that's actually a pretty big deal.
It is. Delaying your bottle like this is really scary. And this was not him farming bad or anything like that. It was just the fact
Radiant's
that
middle tower
the
is under
courier
attack.
Had to be used. So a little bit of a setback, I would say, for him. And also now the room control coming in for him.
Which support do you like more? Do you like Sand King, Ancient Apparition, or Venge and Visage?
I would probably say Sand King AA is good mainly because of the Blink Dagger Centaur that's going to be in their team, but Vengeful Visage is pretty straightforward and really strong in all stages of the game. The swap can be so useful when you have a 4 protect 1 lineup like this, where you protect Spectre as the hard carry. Mm-hmm. And I think Vengeful is underrated.
Oh, in July is going to be in some trouble. You might actually be first blood. Yeah,
oh,
couple hits needed, and that's going to be one more hit. Boom! First
no
blood
self.
Going the way of the AA. That chilling touch really doing its work right there.
Yeah, it kind of shows why AA is such a strong laner in the beginning, just dropping that on both of them. The hits are so amazingly strong. Plus 50 damage for every single hit, and of course, two heroes. 300 damage coming out right there. So, Darkseer is not having a good time. He's still level 1. He's going to head into jungle and try to farm up there, but this means that even now, CIS, they're pretty much just flat out winning top lane. Whereas bottom, we're actually seeing the exact same thing. June has not been able to get anything. Even with his boots first, he has not been able to get a single point of experience.
But he will be now because supports is actually rotated. We've got Super as well as Dreamy U.
As soon as he knows,
mid.
Though, he's very scared still because he can't see them.
Yeah.
The smoke gang always revealed on mid. They're going to get Inflame here, maybe,
they're
but the
no,
boots.
They're not going to get a range.
The boots getting away.
They went for a smoke gang. Why didn't they just wrap around? then they would have had it, but now no.
Like, a little bit too greedy. It's about not wanting to wait too long with your gank, because then it becomes more and more obvious the longer you wait with going. But that was a greedy attempt to go straight forward there, and Dragonite is already a hard hero to kill. You need to get the gang off successfully. Also, I feel it's a little bit sad ganging right before the nighttime. You want to sort of time it to nighttime with Nightstalker, I feel.
Yeah, let's see who's going to take that Invis rune. Going to be the Sand King.
Yeah, passing over the bottle, giving him the Invis, and still bottling the Invis, of course, before using it.
Yeah, Air just got his full bottle delivered, though, and he will be able to survive the gank if Sand King is in Dota right now. And yeah, he knows it too. So Sand King backs off. Might be going mid. He's actually still hanging around. I'm not sure though. Maybe if Dragonite reaches level 6, but that will take some time.
That harass,
now with Sand King.
The harass brief fire right there. That could be what can set up a kill here. If he keeps farming on next wave, the Nightstalker that is, then he's in danger. This Invis rune from demons just standing there. Air pretty much knows that something is up though, and just backs to pick up his bottle again. So safe play by Air. And as expected on the carries, I mean, both of them having completely uncontested free farm, they're pretty much even, 30 CS and 29, but also Spectre is being pushed right now and this Anti-Mage is pushing, so I would say they're pretty much perfect in their farming, or fairly close.
Yeah, in the meantime, Darkseer managed to get level 2. Still not more than that though, as June is actually almost level 3, rotating mid right now with Boots.
Yeah.
Doesn't get a surprise attack on Air though. I think he got scouted out. But
hard to find anything. And even if he got a stun off there, he has 1 point in return. So he doesn't have a single point in Double Edge. And Double Edge is a really strong level 1 spell. 175. So not having it is a weakness if you're going for gank. And actually a Midas build coming out from Spectre here. Not going for drums or power treads or anything like that. That is very, very greedy.
Yeah, I'm not sure what to think of it. It does, again, lay extra pressure on the rest of his teammates to do well. And perhaps now that it's nighttime and the smoke goes out, Air and Super, as well as Dreamy, you can find a
kill. I think I strongly disagree with the Midas, actually. I really don't like it. Because Spectre doesn't benefit that much from extra levels in the early game. And other than that, her illusions don't even get the attack speed from Hand of Midas. I don't know. I don't like it on any level. But this is XDD's choice. It makes him so easy to gang and doesn't really propel his farm that much compared to rushing drums or black. Are you going to get initiated on?
He blinks away. He's
still in danger here.
Yeah, they haunt in. Black gets silenced up. There should be enough damage to take him down. The silence won't last for a very long time though, but they get him visage in the end with the nukage.
Oh, DK is all alone.
Teleporting in. Yeah, he is. I don't know what he was thinking. Only now the center TP in as well, but it's a long TP because he's not going to be the first one there. He's actually going to cancel it.
Yeah.
Two cores for zero. Wow, I did not think that Dragonite would just
suicide. That was amazingly big for Dreamtime, and this is also a power for Spectre. She doesn't leave her lane, but as soon as they get a gank going somewhere, she can just haunt in and help get that kill. And suddenly, five-man Dota on the top lane, and no one was close to Black as he got dove under a tower. That means that the first one to TP in is going to be very lonely as well, the Dragonite. And just a nice play by Dreamtime, really, and that sets them far ahead of the enemy team, really.
Yeah, I'm a bit surprised that both AA and Sand King did not carry a teleport scroll around.
Yeah, both that and also the fact that they were not close to Radiant's the Anti-Mage at all. You should expect a gang to come in on the Anti-Mage during the first nighttime. Like, that's what Nightstalker does. And they didn't really have any defensive wards either that could reveal this.
No, but they realized that Nightstalker was missing. We even saw the Anti-Mage sitting in a jungle knowing, like, okay, you know what? Things are going to get hairy soon. So they should have been aware.
Yeah, I think if they just had a lane ward on top, they would actually back off completely because they would see how many people are actually coming up there on lane. And that's something that you normally do when you have a hard carry and you want to leave him a little bit, like the AA and Sand King are leaving him because Sand King want to farm up in jungle. Then drop a lane ward and the Anti-Mage will know immediately when someone is coming to gang him. But a little bit of a mistake. At least the Sand King is farming up in jungle and gonna soon go for... He's gonna go for a gang first, actually, and then take his stack. See what he's gonna find here. I don't think it's going to be an easy gank, to be honest.
Well, they do have the Dragon Form again, and an Invis rune, actually, as well. So who knows if they can take down the Spectre?
They have no vision. At least here, Spectre, with her build, she has no extra HP at all. So if they go in here with the Invis rune on Dragonite...
Yeah, they will.
This is a kill. Yeah, oh, he stuns a creep!
Whoa, that's huge! And in now comes Super as well. They're going to slow down Inflame. He's going to be in trouble. Soul Storms are coming out. He is going to get saved by the Burrow Strike. Demon's
They're
coming in. Double Burrow Strike.
So
double Edge there as well. Visage dies. Vengeful Spirit dies as well. CIS, oh, they have to be so lucky that they can get those two kills, because
that was
misplay.
Really, that was really poor by both teams, to be honest. Like, it was really, really bad, of course, to stun a creep. Stuff happens. Mistakes, like misclicks happen.
Mm-hmm.
But missing a kill like that when you're in Viz and have all the time in the world to make sure you hit this stun, you should not miss it at all. And then the stack up by Vengeful and Visage, just stacking completely for Sanking and Centaur, that's instant death for both of them. So a lot of mistakes coming out, actually.
Yeah, and they don't get the Dragonite. They were so close.
Yeah, close to killing Dragonite, but he is a very tanky hero. Even with the 2 points now in Dragon Blood, he's just so fat hero.
Yeah, good for CAS in the end, though, as Demas is starting to get more and more rich. He's sitting on 1,100 gold, so that's going to be his Blink Dagger in his 1K.
He has the stack here. If he gets, he's probably going to get another stack as well. So this is going to be a quad stack, and that's when you want to farm it. So the pull looks nice, and he's actually going to get it off. And that's a quad stack. So now with level 2 Sandstorm, you just walk in, Sandstorm that, and he's going to be very close to finish up
columns.
A Blink Dagger.
No Golems.
No.
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 Poor Golems. Won't spawn. Well, actually, it's good for CIS. But
yeah. Well, the stack is... I mean, the stack is hard to kill now that Inflame doesn't have level 2 on his Dragon Form, else he could have killed this really fast. Well, actually, a double damage has been topped for 30 seconds without any of the teams checking this. If he gets that on DK, it's a really good rune. But none of the teams have any rune vision right now. They know it's top because June checked the bottom rune. I'm interested in this gank on top to see if Nightstalker is going to get another kill off with his gank here. Nightstalker is still looking pretty good in this game, 1-0-1, but after losing two heroes on bottom there, this game is kind of evened out a whole lot.
Yeah. Surge up for Vengeful Spirit here on the top lane. They're looking to
this
try and take
a
gank. They see him.
Yeah, Vengeful, very good for giving vision.
He doesn't have a swap, but the Haunt goes in. They might be able to kill him off. He will be able to blink soon. Where's that Nightstalker? Where's the Void? He blinks. There is the Void. There we go. That's a kill. A ult is still going to be enough to kill off the Vengeful Spirit, I think,
Black Blast is so mad. Every single hero coming in just ganking him. The Spectre is actually working out really nice in that regard, because she is adding that extra bit of damage and forcing him to blink that is needed. Like, if Spectre did not ulti, they would not get this kill.
True.
But just adding the kill potential. Also, Vengeful works really well for him, giving that vision when he blinks into a jungle. And she's been on point, Dream U, finding him when it blinks in.
He's still level 5, though. Under attack. I mean, in terms of level, there's three heroes
Radiant's
on the side of DT that are still level 5.
Attack.
Yeah.
Including that Darkseer, which, I mean, Centaur is almost level 7 already. That's a big difference right there. And Darkseer is one of those heroes that really needs his levels as well. So I'm kind of scared for DT that
attack.
They can still make this hero worth its while, as he is actually going to be the one to find a double damage rune.
Yeah, it's been there for 2 minutes, actually, that rune in mid. Are they going to try and chase down here an Inflame? They have a TP in, but it's so slow. Visage not getting there in time. But one good thing that CIS have going for him right now
Radiant's
is the fact that they have level 6 on Ancient Apparition.
Mm-hmm.
Mid tower gets denied, of course, by Dreamtime, as no pressure was added. But now, I don't think they can stop this pressure on mids. There's double damage and
they have a Blink Dagger on tanking.
Yeah, maybe, but he has to back to base first. He doesn't have mana enough to use his combo. Actually, just gonna dive here on Io.
Yeah, why not? Why not just kill the Ancient Apparition? Easy kill. The Dragonite's around there as well. He no longer has his Dragon Form. He would actually be a very nice skill to get as well.
Radiant's top
losing his Dragon Form could be hard to stop. The pressure on mid, but of course they might want to send someone top to just take that, and Darkseer is going to be happy to do so. Needs the level so badly, but I think as soon as they have Blink Dagger on Centaur as well as the Sand King, then the AoE ulti is going to come into play and it can start being aggressive and actually doing something. Because so far we've seen exactly what we kind of said during the drafting stage, that Nightstalker, it is a driver's seat kind of hero. They have been controlling
attack.
This game and sending the ganks towards the enemy safe lane and just controlling the pace. And interesting to see that the Spectre goes back for the face boots drums after buying the Midas. But she's really farmed at this point. Even though she's behind Black in CS, 11 CS behind, she's still ahead so far in network.
Yeah, she is going to be getting ganked right now, though, as they use everything to blow her up. Epicenter as well. Demons Dyer's almost dies from it. But
that's some commitment, though. That is some commitment. Yeah. So top lane, meanwhile. Actually, Demon's going to go down here to Visage. Bird's just chasing him down. And Dyer's meanwhile, they also lose the top tower. Fallen. So this is not that great after all for CIS. Sure, you kill off the Spectre, but you're losing a whole lot as well. And even a little bit of a missed micro, Visage Bird gets killed.
And she didn't lose that much gold. She didn't have that much before she died. She already had just bought the phase and drums.
Yeah, and she had some reliable gold, so not going to be able to lose that gold.
Middle tower is
so
under
just
attack.
Fine, but Dreamtime, I like what they did there, just going top and removing the tier 1 tower on top lane. Oh, actually going to try and go for a killer on Centaur.
And she gets it too.
XDD and jumps back as well. That extra reality. I love when they added that attack, so you can reality more than once.
Yeah.
And using it quite well there. Haste rune on DK though. He's just going to harass this tower down. Might even get it if no one comes to stop.
Nah, they
there
won't.
We go.
And actually the burst still gets the stun off, but the haste rune is going to allow Inflame to get away. Haste rune is almost running out. But at least they don't get the tower there. So far, the towers are even. Both teams have taken out one tower thus far.
Yeah, towers are even. I like that Dragonite just forced a hole up there and forced the enemy to TP down, so they probably know that the enemy are going to go for some 5-man push bottom, or at least not a gank on black right now, when you see Vengeful and Visage TP in like that. Kind of smoke behind here. Inflame is ready for it, though. Oh, they predicted this.
Burrow strike up onto the AO flying out of where Air is going to get nuked down. The last one there, 3 dead. Dragonite almost drops. Might actually go down to his own illusion. Visage, where's that Soul Sarge? No mana actually will end up going down. Courier will live 4 dead.
Not a single loss, but solo HP on both tanking.
And look at XDD. He actually came back and XDD goes down as well. He wanted to just really get that Sand King, but
that's
everybody
5 heroes
dies.
Dead.
That's
and
insane.
Look at the HP on the Sand King, the Dragonite. Even the Centaur was pretty low in that fight.
Yep.
But that was really nice by CIS. The way they read this, they forced the TPs to bottom lane. Yep. And then they were like, 5-man Dota
what
should be around
do?
Bottom. And look at the ward. The Observe ward actually spotted out when they walked and smoked.
Yep.
Forgot to say that. But as they walked around, it was pretty obvious to them. And they had perfect positioning to catch them out.
Yeah, great stun from June as well there.
Oh yeah.
To set things up. And that's CIS completely back in the game. I mean, yeah, Spectre might still be a little bit richer than Anti-Mage, but this fight, Anti-Mage is almost finished with his Butter Fury.
Yeah.
This and that fight just delays the game so much that Anti-Mage is going to get a lot of extra time.
Yeah. This is not a very fast Battle Fury, though. We're looking at 16 minutes in, and he still haven't finished it. So the ganks have definitely been paying off on Anti-Mage and setting him back. But I think with this 5-man kill, now CIS, they want to force a little bit and get this bottom tower. They know it's low HP. Meanwhile, though, Black has to be careful and know that the enemy are coming for him.
Yeah, Sand King just placing a new Observer ward there as well. I think it just got scouted out, but
don't get greedy, Black. This is where, apart from just hitting creeps and trying to carry a game by getting farmed, this is where a carry has to be very disciplined to just back off when you have to. If you stay too long, it's just
Dire's
so easy to get picked off.
Are fortified.
Definitely.
AOT is coming in, gonna try and defend his tower. TPing in as well with Dragon Knight. But I think they're just scaring them off.
Actually, Vengeful Spirit. Why didn't she back earlier? She'll go down, but she could have backed up faster.
She's a slow hero, and she was also standing within attack range on the tower. Keep in mind, that's 400 range on Vengeful, so she was a little bit further ahead than she should have been.
Mm-hmm.
Of course, it was like Nightstalker and Darkseer, etc. They're really fast at getting away. But they got another pick there. Courier actually goes down to these Visage Birds, right? Yes, the Visage Birds killed the Courier.
Yep.
So that's a big thing. In this stage of the game, it's pretty much worth more than a hero kill. Even the experience you get for killing a hero is not making up for all that gold you feed by a Courier kill.
Is under attack. Well, the Familiar Birds are also making sure that this tower is going to get chipped away slowly but steadily. And I think they should be able to get the tower maybe with the next go. No, they're not even going
to.
No,
they have
not
to run away. No, IO is just here and camping it. Interesting to see the XDD is going for probably a Diffusal build. We will see maybe a Yasha build as well on him. He could go for either, but I would probably expect a Diffusal now with this type
top
of build.
Tower is under
so not
attack.
Going for the Radiance at all. Interesting. Oh, Inflame, he actually runs in here with his Invis on mid lane.
Yeah. It's a shame for him. He doesn't have his Dragon form just yet, but at least he can get close to someone for a Dragon Tail. Right now, the only one that's close to him would be a core, and that's not really someone that he could take down.
Paws comes out. Look at Visage just sending in his birds once more on the mid lane. He's going to have to stone for him really early now because they're not that high HP. But he's just being a complete nuisance on the mid lane.
Yeah, been a complete annoyance.
Yeah. So Nightstalker almost has his entire BKB finished. And during the next nighttime, if he finishes up the BKB in a good timing, they could probably start taking some fights again and just forcing the enemy around. Also, 2 gold to mech on Darkseer. So these are 2 really huge items, changing the way the fights will turn out.
Yeah.
But one thing to keep in mind is, if you get Blink initiated by Sand King and then follow up by Centaur, or even the other way around, and then AA to burst you and Dragonite nearby, it does not matter what item you have. BKB, mech, it will not save you. So reaction time and just knowing where CIS are is really important for Dreamtime.
Yeah. And the smoking that's done by CIS right now, I don't think it will find a target. XDD is actually backing off, realizing that he would be too far out. Right now, one of the things that I'm really concerned about for DT is that Spectre just needs a lot of extra farm before he can really be able to be on par with that anti-mage. And he doesn't have the space to do that. There are wards on, there's aggressive wards, but those won't help Spectre from farming. There's 2 wards in a dire jungle. There's 1 ward in the mid lane, but he does not have a safe jungle. He does not have a safe bottom lane.
Yeah, and a lot of that comes from the fact that they never pushed on their safe lane. Like, sometimes you want to push, sometimes you want to keep it static. They never chose to remove the tier 1 tower on CIS bottom lane, or the tier 2 Dire's tower. If you get rid of both of these towers, attack. It's so much harder to gang the Spectre in this game. But when you don't do it, it's easy to TP down there. And even if you take a fight there, it's easy to buy back, travel, or TP down again to that tower. So it does change a little bit, and Spectre should not get too greedy in terms of bottom lane. But she's very disciplined and actually backs off. Meanwhile, Black is hanging around mid, just pissed at these Visage birds. They keep annoying the tower.
I think everybody would be pissed at these Visage birds.
Yeah. And tier 1 towers, of course, never have any backdoor regen, so you can just keep sending them like this. Mm-hmm. But I believe that even against the Visage birds are annoying no matter which tower it is, because as soon as you have any creep nearby, it's just going to add that pushing power.
Yep. And that's going to be the birds on hold again.
Yeah. Tower is not deniable, but Centaur is going to come in and defend. One thing I'm a little bit concerned right now is that Dreamtime, this seems like they're just moving around, not sure where to go. They're going to go up and try to force Black to blink away and not farm that much in his own jungle, but CIS have a lot of control right now. Sand King is even farming the enemy jungle with Sandstorm. Should probably pick up a TP scroll so that he's ready to counter gank for his team.
Mm-hmm.
But other than that, it's XDD, he's farming, trying to farm here. Actually gonna get Epicenter, I think. AA. Sending in the ulti. XDD is gonna go down to this.
Yep, there he goes. Nicely done. Just 2 heroes needed to take him down. 2 supports to take down the Spectre. That's a gigantic kill for them.
Yeah, and AA not even having to run there. That's amazing as a pick-off. And mid tower, look at it. It had 1 HP or something, and it gets denied. So not a whole lot going the way of DT right now. And that was just good positioning by the Sand King, farming enemy jungle, being ready. He Dire's saw the Spectre move in from the lane to the creep cam and just capitalized.
With the Epicenter on cooldown, though, it looks like Dreamtime thinks that they can actually take a fight here on top. They're actually
Nighttime about to pop in as well, and they have the BKB available. June just canceling his stomp over and over.
Get out of here, you man.
Scaring the enemy away.
Tower is under attack.
Stun you.
Yeah.
Oh, darkness is popped, though, or at least rather it's nighttime. Not yet darkness. They want to go for the Dragonite in a little bit too far. Already dead before the fight's
that BKB
even
is so good.
Way. Io in some trouble. Will not be able to teleport out. Blink away from demons. He'll be able to go, but June not so lucky. Down as well. 3 dead here for CIS. DT, they're going to be able to take a tower off the back of this. Unfortunately for them, Anti-Mage is not shut down, because he is still happily farming.
And this is actually a bad fight for CIS to even think about taking, to be honest. Because when you have Anti-Mage farming so much, the enemy carry being dead, and then Anti-Mage just abusing the enemy jungle, and even pushing out to the towers, you don't want to take that fight. Anti-Mage is fine. In this regard, it would be okay to lose your tier 2 tower, but you don't want to lose 3 heroes and your tier 2 tower. That's giving away too much.
Mm-hmm.
So it's making Black's job a little bit harder in terms of carrying. And this early on, you cannot TP in with Anti-Mage to take the fight. You can't really help against this type of dive. You need to have Manta Style ready, and he has 4k gold, but he still needs 1k to get the entire recipe and the ultimate orb.
Yeah, close to having that Manta Style, but for now has to wait. So DT, after that fight on top lane, they actually went back to farming. I was expecting them to try and take something more off the back of it, but they didn't really do that.
It's quite okay. Like, you get the tower and you get 3 kills, you back off and pick up some new items, like reorganize. It's dangerous to pressure too much as well, especially when Haunt is on cooldown. Oh, and the Spectre went for the Diffusal Blade as well instead of the Manta Style build. So his illusions hit really hard. The mana burn from Diffusal Blade is really annoying.
So far, we have got ourselves a Visage with a Medallion. We don't have a Roshan taken down yet, though. He's still up. 22 minutes into the game, no Roshan being done. What are you expecting for that? Like, are you expecting a Roshan soon? Or
Dreamtime, if they win one big fight again, they could probably take a Roshan because they have the Medallion. They have the damage to actually kill it. Over on CIS, though, it's very obvious as soon as they want to go for a Roshan. I think they're going to have to... It's the same. They need to take a Clash first. And neither of the teams should be able to sneak a Roshan. Look at this smoke gang, Dreamtime. I think it's obvious to CIS though, but are they gonna get away with it?
Or are they? Silence up already for Black to swap as well. The stun comes out.
Dead.
They should be able to take him down. There he goes, looking for the next target. The wall is there as well though, coming out from the darks here, and it looks like they can get the Sand King. Dragonite might be in some trouble, flying through the wall, turns on a BKB. That should be enough for him to back out. 3 alive for CIS.
Yeah, and even earning up now on the Spectre as well. Vengeful has 3 earn charges remaining after that fight. Mm-hmm. So I think they might be able to get this tower. Gonna try and press it down. Dragonite pulling the creeps away though, and Glyph available as well.
Yeah, that was the first BKB charge of the Dragonite actually.
That's actually a second. They used one on top as well and allowed him to dive in really hard.
No, so Dragonite used only one.
So oh, on the Dragonite, yes. I thought about Night Stalker.
Yeah, I know that.
And yeah, the Dragonite didn't get anything done really with the BKB there.
Not at all.
Sure, he didn't get focused, but there was nothing that could possibly save Antimage. When he gets swapped there and immediately targeted down, he can't get away because he does not have a Manta Style or anything like that, and he can't get rid of the silence. So
he used it to get away himself.
Yeah.
I am surprised again that DT, I mean, yay, they want to fight, awesome. But they don't actually take a tier 2 tower, nor do they take Roshan.
It's just hard at that point. They forced out at least a Glyph, but it's hard to keep pressing when you don't have any creeps pushing in. The Dragonite managed to pull them away. So I think it's reasonable to just back off and give nothing back to CIS. CIS, they got a lot of kills earlier on in the game, but right now, as long as Dreamtime don't feed back, we're going to see them inch their way back into this game. And it's interesting to look at the experience graph actually in this game. CIS were so far ahead, and now with these kills coming in for Dreamtime, this could be their way back into the game in terms of experience. I think this is a lot about Vengeful and Visage not being able to farm compared to Sand King, who's level 11. Mm-hmm. Getting solo kill as well, and the Spectre gave him a lot of experience.
Yeah. The gold graph tells the same story, actually.
Yeah.
Was in favor of CAS, and DT is just coming right back. And they're doing a good job at it, too. We've got the Diffusal up on the Spectre already. She's starting to build her own Yasha by the looks of things. Her own Manta Style mm-hmm. will help with the pushing, which is something that DT doesn't necessarily have apart from the Visage Birds.
Yeah, and Black is now with the next creep camp here, Dyer's finally gonna finish up his Manta Style. It's a little bit late as you want to have like a 20-22 minute Manta Style. He's on 25 and a half, it's
Dyer's
okay, but
tower has fallen.
There's so much pressure being added by DT. We saw the fight on mid, we saw the fight on top, and now even the pressure on bottom again. And Antimage is just not ready yet, he needs more time.
Dream Team is not going to let it go. They are actually with 4 people bottom. Keep in mind, they would be with 5.
If they get spotted, though,
he's here.
This ward is showing them, so I think they're not going to get anything out of it because they're completely spotted out by the ward from CIS.
And the Dragonite is there as well.
They're actually going to dive in behind. Dragonite does have a BKB available, though.
Yeah, where's the rest of the TP's only coming now? Inflame already backing off. Black also in some trouble. He is still alive though. We'll be able to run. Vacuum in. June, he'll be the first one to die. Inflame and Black backing off. Still though, it is 1 hero dead on the side of CIS while they were aware at what Dreamtime was doing. So that was a bit weird.
I'm surprised that they get caught by that. They completely saw the enemy move around and behind the tower. Like, they should know exactly what was going on there. I think they were just underestimating the power of DT. and feeling like they were more ahead. But Dreamtime, when they get to focus you with five heroes hitting you like that, you die really fast. That centaur just evaporated. And I don't even think he had time to use his mech before he died. So Dreamtime, just gonna keep controlling this game. And again, they didn't get a tier 2 tower for this. But again, it's just a pick-off. So they get the kill, and I think this is pretty fine for them.
And Dragonite sitting on 2,500 gold, by the way. What do you expect him to build? Because there's a lot of different Dragonite builds out there.
Oh, they are. I would probably expect something like a Maelstrom into Mjolnir build.
Not and just an AC or something like that?
AC is also good, but it's just the fact that you have both the Centaur and the Dragonite. It's a matter of who will get it. Later on in the game, I think they should have both. But Mjolnir is probably the better item to get first, just a farming transition. But both items are just fine. Dragonite is a little bit customizable from game to game, I guess. But I would like to see him add up a Maelstrom so he can actually kill creeps himself. Because right now he's just running around and trying to be ready for the ganks. But he's not getting that much more gold himself. And Nightstalker now only 400 gold away from that Aghanim's. And as I said, Aghanim's is a great item this game. Not only because when Antimage blinks away, but you scout out heroes. You will see the Centaur, you will see the Sanking before they blink your team. Makes it so much easier to take the fights.
I feel very sad for this Nightstalker. He was standing in front of the creep camp to stack it.
Oh.
And then he disconnected.
Yeah.
Poor. That's a bit of a shame.
Poor Nightstalker. DC.
And DC again for the second time, which is unusual because they are playing from a LAN setting, which is why also we, for example, do not have any delays in the stream.
Yeah.
Meaning that if there are overlay issues, we can have them fixed straight away. It's all good.
It's very nice. One thing that I think is really fun to look at in this game is the kill scores. Because when you look at that, you can see that on the time of Dreamtime, they have 9 assists on 3 heroes. And this just goes to tell how much they have been 5-man ganking the CIS.
Yeah. There's 12 kills in total, and Darkseer, Venge, Spectre all has been involved in 10 of those.
Yeah, Nightstalker as well also have been in 10. So it's just a lot of train stratting from Dreamtime, and it's what you expect, like the ganks. You kind of want to 5-man gank, and Spectre is always one of the heroes with the highest assist scores because she just pops her ulti every single fight that she can.
Yeah, and it has been working out great. She's pretty farmed, more
it
farmed
has been.
Than the... actually, no longer more farmed than the Antimage, but...
Just barely passed in net worth. Sure, the Antimage has way higher CS, 250 at this point, compared to 145. But the Antimage is also 1-3-1, whereas the Spectre is looking... You know, she's 1-3, sure, but she has 9 kills. So she has been getting some gold from these assists, jumping in and helping her team. Also, just the tower advantage. But I think this game is far from over. Dreamtime, sure, they look pretty okay right now. But when you look over to the experience, it's still CIS that's ahead. Yeah. The gold, sure. But I think that Black, playing his signature Antimage, it's very scary to go up against late game.
When he is done farming, things will get different for DT for sure. Because who do you think, if this game goes on for another 30 minutes, who do you think will come out ahead in terms of carry potential? Often it's said that Spectre... is one of the hardest carries, but then again, so is Antimage. So who's going to be coming out ahead there?
And I think in pure carry, I would probably say Spectre is a little bit stronger, but it's just a combination of the lineup from CIS. There is so... Like, they have so good stuns. Actually, going for a kill here, XCD.
That was a bait. You got baited, XCD, and you're dead.
Why did he chase after?
Well, it looked like an easy kill, because he could still haunt after Blink, and... You know, but there were two people sitting around there, and
that was questionable, really questionable.
Oh, but and Shadowblade for Dragonite. I'm not sure if I agree with that one. It's a nice item, but whoa, Dragonite dodges a stun, goes for the BKB, goes for a stun up on the bench as well. Where is that help? Is there any help? No help.
Oh,
not even a
mech. He wants that Shadowblade right now, so he can get away.
Yep.
It's gonna fly in. It's very close actually, but he gets stunned up, and there is a Sentry Ward as well on this vengeful.
And there is the Shadowblade. That means that Dragonite will live and Juno will die.
No, vengeful could have killed the Dragonite as well.
Yeah, they had dropped a Sentry actually.
If she dropped a Sentry, she could have swapped him, even four-staffed. She could have won a lot of things, so he gets away with his life, and I feel he should probably have died there. But
if he didn't have a Shadowblade, he would have died. I take back what I said.
Yeah, I'm surprised he got away with this time. Just a little bit slow reactions from DreamEU. But this is still good for CIS in terms of killing the enemy carry. It's so huge. It's really, really big. And now Antimage farming up the stack here on the Ancients. And he has a Vladimir's coming out as well, so he can farm Ancients much easier and even kill Roshan solo if he wants to. Wonder if he's going to go and try it right away. He will. But the Visage Birds are already on the way.
Yep.
He might get this, to be honest, just because Dreamtime are kind of out of position right now.
Oh, there's always a Spectre that can haunt in. And Antimage does take quite a bit of damage. And he'll actually be scared from the birds alone. I mean, in terms of vision, it's really poor for CIS.
Yeah.
This is the only ward that they have. And
yeah, it's pretty bad. Oh, look at the Ancient Aberration, actually. This build, he started out saying that, hey, I'm going to go for staff. And then he was like, nah, the game is going pretty good for me. I'm feeling pretty rich.
Aghanims.
I'm just going to keep this wizardry, keep this Ring of Regen as a casual ring, and just go into a point booster for an Aghanims instead. So I like that he can adjust his item decision in a game. Some people are very static in terms of what they will buy and pretty much always follow the same line. But this is just a good decision, I think, in this game. Because Ancient Aberration ulti, it does, if you get it on someone, it doesn't matter if they BKB, it will still be on top of them. They can't heal up. It doesn't deal damage for sure, but there's only one BKB hero as well. So if you hit the enemy team, it's going to be so strong, and he is really important. The AA needs to follow up on a Sand King and Centaur.
That's actually, Darkseer also has a BKB. 10 seconds.
Oh, he actually has one.
Yep,
yeah.
He completed his. And Nightstalker's BKB is still at... No, that's not true.
It's getting lower.
Oh, look, that's a bug.
It's down to 6 seconds.
It says that it's 10 seconds in the item screen, though.
Oh, that is true. Report.
Yep.
Let's talk to Ice Frog after this game.
Yeah, we
report.
Will.
Report. Either way, I think that CIS are in a pretty okay spot in this game, even though it looks like they are falling behind. But it's so even that every slight mistake is going to hurt you. Like,
yeah.
Spectre going up and trying to get a kill on Antimage there was very greedy. I don't think there's any way that she can get a solo kill on him. Even with her ulti and the Diffusal Blade, it was just trying to get something that is so unlikely to happen. And joke's on you, there were two heroes behind him and you die immediately. So
yep.
I just think that small mistakes like this in this game could cost you so much. And potentially the next mistake should probably be a Roshan. With Vladimir's now down on Antimage.
Yeah, so apparently we're waiting for ping to get lower for the players. So when they can play again, there we go. There's going to be a go again, and that is right about now. So,
yeah,
good.
Everyone is ready, so let's get back into this. I like the Nightstalker, though, having his Aghanims now. Sure, it's daytime for a long time now. But during the next nighttime, I think they will have a lot easier time pushing the tier 2 towers down and even fighting around Roche Pit. This Aghanims is going to help them a lot, I think.
Oh, I think that we're going to see a snipe on Spectre, at least attempted. They needed an AA ult?
Yeah, they sent an AA ult earlier, so they're going to have to wait a little bit for a cooldown and try to send a second one. And Ventual is even around here just warding up and trying to keep him safe. Spectre is paying some respect to the last gang, though.
Yeah.
Look at her just backing off.
For sure.
And this is where Antimage
is just wasting time.
Yeah, and Antimage is just saying never stop and keeps farming. So Spectre, without the Radiance build, you don't farm amazingly fast in jungle. And if you can't be on the lane because of the Sand King, then I think AM is going to pull ahead a little bit in farm.
Yeah, they kind of need to find some more fights. Look at this gank set up bottom lane. Even June is there right now, just waiting.
Yeah.
Waiting for someone to start farming here on this bottom lane, but...
Yeah,
no,
but
says XDD.
They're just sticking around on mid lane a whole lot as well, though. Gotta look for an attempt at killing Inflame. They do have the swap available. And could potentially kill him here.
Oh, I think he just walked into range of the tower.
Yeah, may have been revealed there. They have brought this tower pretty low already with the Visage Birds. Just every single time they have been in tower with creeps, the Visage Birds have been there to deal the damage.
Yeah, and then since they can't take a kill, perhaps they can take a tower at least. Inflame is still sitting there, of course, behind the tower, so it won't be easy. And Antimage actually came bottom to maybe try and help with the tier 2 tower
the
on bottom
push,
lane.
Yeah.
Yeah,
both teams just trying to go for some form of trade here. I think CIS are very ready to try and defend the tier 2 on mid, but I wonder if Dreamtime are actually ready to defend bottom. Gonna TP in with Darks here, but that's all.
Should be enough. A couple of iron shells scare off CIS.
It scares the enemy team, scares them off, especially with the Nightstalker popping his ulti. Reduces some of your vision and just feels scary and intimidating. So, seems both towers are going to stand, and this is just a positioning game right now. As we said, next mistake is probably going to cost whichever team commits the mistake. It's going to cost them a lot.
Yeah, Roshan.
Yes, Roshan is the biggest danger, and also when the tier 2 tower on mid is so low HP for CIS, they will lose this immediately if they lose a team fight or anything like that.
Yeah, and I actually think that DT feels like kind of the pressure of the farming anti-mage. They're rotating mid with all of their players. Even Spectre is here right now, which is not someone that you would normally expect to be there.
Yeah,
with
he's
the rest
of here to push. He's going to pop the Mantis out probably and just punch down on this tower. They kind of have to if they want to kill this tower.
Oh, anti-mage, careful. The sun is already gone, though, up on this Dragonite Stampede. Gets everybody of CIS out there and are actually initiating back in, vacuum into the wall. Epicenter there as well. So far, it's only Visits that dies, though, in July, backing off from this fight again as Inflame finds himself the Vengeful Spirit. Should be able to take it down with one extra stun. Oh, June, XED will end up dropping there at the back of the fight. Three dead already, DT two alive, and they'll run.
Yeah, that's a big win for CIS. Sure, you lose your anti-mage, but they win that fight pretty convincingly. They have their urns available, so they can go straight into Roche pit here if they want to, or push down mid. Actually, the Roche damage is not that amazing, so better just to take the mid tower out if you can. Dragonite being an amazing pusher. And he has the Hyperstone up as well now, so with Shadow Blade, his power treads and Hyperstone, his damage is quite considerable. Oh, never mind that. He has the Vengeance Aura on him, the negative Vengeance Aura. So
minus Vengeance.
His damage aura is his damage is not considerable. It's useless. Under attack. And there it will get removed as soon as she respawns.
Yeah, still pretty good. Pretty good, I should say. He'll get a haste as well. Even though CIS won that fight without their anti-mage, fair enough.
Yeah.
They also don't really get anything in return for that fight, though. No Aegis for them.
Yeah,
meaning that the Roche fight will have to wait for another day because neither of the teams will want to give it up, and both teams have got some kind of coverage close by.
Yeah, so in the end, it's not a huge victory for CS. Sure, you won and you killed more heroes, and that's important, but they didn't get towers, didn't get Roshan, so the game is still open for either team. And look at Air just looking for something here with his Aghanims and Gem. Not gonna find this 4-step Blink sanking, though. Very hard hero to pick off.
Yeah, it's just Centaur that's around there still in the trees, who will now also blink away. His TP is off again in 9 seconds. I mean, normally in the trees you're safe, but with the Nightstalker with the Aghanims and Gem on the deck, well, you have to be blinking, extra away. So that's what he did. June is safe to TP out now if he wants to so far.
Yeah, I like how this AA ulti on mid lane actually has three heroes in their smoke. I think it was just aiming to kill the creep wave, but three heroes just getting lower in terms of HP, and AA farming up jungle here with Sand King. They're both going to be fine, I guess. Black might get intercepted here. Has his Manta style available, though. Can pop the silence immediately.
Yeah, they're still able to blink away. Oh, get swapped and stunned. What a brilliant combination. Black, Soul Sumption coming out. He'll still be able to blink away with the negative urn charge on him. Might take him down enough. In flame, in some trouble, but his BKB will
allow
him
to just walk out of there.
And Vengeful Spirit actually gets
that
lasted
was so
with
close.
The urn charge.
The urn, it was battling against
it
his
was
regen.
The last urn charge as well.
Yeah, and I... Oh, that is so sad. That is so sad for him. Very close to living, actually.
That is quite insane. They only got that kill, fair enough.
Yeah.
But that's 100% worth it. As said, this will also allow them to take down the tower right now. Fortification at least forced out.
Yeah.
It's something with an A-ult coming in as well. It's just
seems they're going to lose this tower no matter what. Going to try and defend with Dragon Knight or even get a deny. Doesn't get the deny. It's going to have to back off. I think this could even be the point where they just walk in on Roche and force a buyback or something. Or even just get the Roche. But
maybe, but
gotta
so
play
far,
it more
no.
safe.
No Roche just yet.
Nightstalker does find this ward here. It's already done, you know, most of its job is 120 remaining on its timer, so gonna get dewarded anyway, but not a huge deward.
Nope, it's the only ward that was still left for the map for CIS, which is kind of a shame for them.
For any team, actually. Both the wards are gone.
There's one ward still standing here. And there is a gem on Dragonite, so if they pass that, they'll see it. But the thing is, right now, when a team has wards, often you see... for example, in pubs, often you see, okay, they have a ward, so I'll stop warding because they can see them anyway. not the case. You have to just find those ward positions where your enemy team will not pass through and you'll still be having a useful ward.
You gotta be sneaky.
Yeah.
Being a support is a lot about mind games and where you ward. Sometimes even walking up and trying to fake ward, like just walking somewhere, trying to fool your opponent. I talked to some supports about this and yeah, it's just, you gotta be active as a ward hero because it makes the huge difference to your team. If you can see the map and the enemy can't, it's so much easier for your entire team to play it out.
Yeah. Oh, this courier might be in some trouble soon.
Yeah, poor courier. Actually, the dropping the anti-tinker ward here, I'm not entirely sure why they dropped this. I guess they're scared of like the Darkseer hiding or something. Or birds. I don't know. Demons being some next level player at least. It's still some decent vision, I guess, that it gives, but
it's
also not going to get dewarded, right? Less chance of it, at least.
Well, if Nightstalker
may
close,
see it, yeah.
If he stands right here, then he'll see it anyways.
Yeah, but it's just if you play against Nightstalker with Gem, you can't really drop straight up lane wards, so I guess it's okay, the ward that he dropped.
Aghanim's AA.
Yeah, that's pretty scary, actually, because this Spectre, she has to be afraid of Sand King and AA trying to burst her. But now, the pressure on bottom, I think CIS are going to fight for this tower.
Yeah, they want to. So far, we are lacking, of course, the Spectre, but she can haunt in when need be. For other heroes.
BKB on Antimage, by the way. A 10-second BKB available in this. He does not have buyback, so if he dies, it's pretty huge. Vengeful, trying to find something here.
This is the second wave of Visage Familiars that just got dropped, by the way.
Oh, so
there's no familiars for another
130 seconds. That's more than 2 minutes of no Visage Birds. So quite a big opening, and especially Visage Birds are important to check Roshan and check if the enemy is in on Roshan, stuff like that. Mm-hmm. And I'm pretty sure that CIS are aware of this as well, that the birds are gone.
Yeah, just a wave of terror right now to scout it out. Without giving too much away, without really running in yourself and trying to get that. There goes the Salt Crest for the Dragonite, so he'll have that in the next fight. Also, just like Antimage though, bought out for it, so no buyback for him either.
It's pretty big to have both the Salt Crest and the Vladimir's, because now they have really good defense against pure right-clicks. And Dreamtime, most of their damage is actually just right-clicks. Like, they have the Vengeful for extra damage, and with the Wave of Terror, even more damage from right clicks being added, but Spectre, the Visage Birds, Nightstalker, most of these just right clickers, to be honest. So I like it from CIS. Gonna make them so much tankier, and especially Dragonite, of course. Super hard to bring down at this point.
With the gold graph being fairly even, experience graph not really changing anymore that much in the last few minutes either, which team would you say is ahead? 40 minutes into the game, 15-15 gold graph.
I think it's
from
much
Moncaris, it's
I think
same.
This is a good position for CIS. I think so. Because they have easier time going for the Roche. I'm going to try and snipe it now, but this is not going to be a free Roche. Dreamy U going to scout it out with a Wave of Terror. They could commit to this, but it's kind of scary. Sand King should be initiating.
Oh, wow. That's going to be Dreamy U already dead. Vacuum is there, though. Whoa, maybe slightly too late. BKB's turned on air, as well as in July. Might be trying to run right now. His Ancient Operation still gets dropped. Anti-Mage comes in, or rather, Anti-Mage does try to get out again. XCD was able to get the Dragonite down, and there goes the gem as well. Black goes for Mana Void, but there's
oh,
really
Black, you can't fight that.
No,
XCD is too strong.
I don't know why he went for Mana Void on the Spectre that still was having half of his mana.
Yeah, but this is really huge, and Roshan is still fairly tanky compared to the HP of heroes right now. June trying to find something.
Anti-Mage actually bought back.
Yeah, I think they will get Roshan now for sure with CIS, but wow, what a performance in that fight by XDD, to be honest. He killed the Dragonite really fast because he went on him with his Manta Style, isolated the Dragonite so he had no friend close to him, and that's when Desolate comes into play. We're talking about how Dragonite is a super tanky hero, very hard to kill. Well, he's still a 1600 HP hero, and if you can bypass the armor by Desolate damage, you can actually kill him. Oh, this AA ulti. This is going to bring down XDD, maybe. I'm not sure. No, he should be fine. Or actually, the Aghanim's upgrade, he should still be fine.
Dropping his phase boost to get a cloak.
Oh, he dies. Wow. Oh, he picked up a heart. What? Oh, that's... What? He just picked up a heart and died. What?
He died because of the heart pickup.
Yeah. You can't increase your HP because when... If you pick up an item that increases your HP when you have AA ulti on you,
or higher
exactly, you won't heal because you have AA ulti on you. So percentage-wise, your HP will shrink right there, and that's why you shattered. So yeah, that was really bad.
And he was just so smart enough to get that cloak, right?
He bought a cloak, and I like that part, but he also picked up the heart. Oh, man.
Yeah.
He probably sits there and punches his keyboard right now because he was going to be just fine.
He was going to live.
He was a liver. Not
at
anymore.
Least lucky for him, he spent his gold before he died. You know, he bought a useful club.
Yeah, at least he bought something.
Ooh, I like this, though. Sand King has got himself a veil.
Yeah. The veil is going to add a lot of extra damage, actually. Yep. And look at Black blinking in on the Vengeful here.
Yeah, Vengeful turns around for a stun that gets dodged by Black, but there should not be a kill on the Venge anymore, especially not since he's now behind our tower. It would be too far to dive.
Yeah.
Although maybe Inflame is going to allow it. Maybe they're actually rotating all top, so they want to make something happen.
They are. They have the Aegis on Black, I mean, so they probably want to just take a fight straight up, because now they have all their ultis available. They could just go. And I actually think that they are stronger in a fight, but they're probably a little bit intimidated by last fight. Spectre really showed how strong she can be, because she killed off Dragon Knight really fast, and then she man-fought against Black and completely just destroyed him as well. So I don't think they want to underestimate Spectre. That's probably why they're not taking a fight yet.
In July, picking up Scythe of Ice while moving past the secret shop.
Yeah.
And taking out another ward from the Dire side. So looking for a fight. Oh, actually, Inflame is going to be the first one there, but he's already being spotted out. That Aghanim's before the Night Stalker doing its work. BKB's turned on. In comes the wall. Air, though, already dead. Vacuum is still there. Io, he's still alive. He's actually the most squishy one, and he's going to be chased down by XDD. Two hits should do the job. There
nice
we go.
Ulti,
and actually, that's going to be Basher for Black, or at least stun on XDD. He's not going to be able to make it out. He'll go down. For the second time, they might be getting the Vengeful Spirit still as well. Actually, Venge is already back home, but in July, getting chased down by Black. And Black should be able to get this. Actually, the double edge from Mega Long Range is getting that one.
That was so huge. They couldn't really burst down anyone during the haunt. And Spectre tried to chase after there, find that kill on AA, but he got his ulti out first. And then three heroes just manned up and killed that Spectre. While Sand King actually got a kill on the Visage in the backline as well, completely on his own. So that was an amazing fight by CIS, but all of it was really attributed to the fact they stunned Nightstalker before he used the BKB, and
he got killed off.
Yeah, he was just brought away.
Mission.
Yeah, and they even kept the Aegis on Antimage, so this push is really
fun. This might actually be the tier 3 tower. There's no buyback available on Spectre as they actually fight. Wow,
nice pick.
What's he doing there?
Too close?
Yeah.
Too close. You have to pay respect to the blink daggers, especially when CIS have a carry like Antimage, you can follow up so easily. And Black doesn't care at all about all this harass being thrown his way.
He still has his BKB sitting on 8 seconds. He's actually going to get silenced off, though. Might be in some trouble, but it's going to be Super that's going to be dead.
Same story again.
Whoa, that's going to be trouble. Maybe now Black's still going to be okay. TP's coming in. He also comes to Darkseer, getting stunned when he gets out. They're trying to chase down Black Air with his BKB. Only 4 seconds, though, so his BKB's already gone, and Black gets an urn charge. Still could try and turn and burn this, because he still has that Aegis.
Yeah, but now the regeneration actually... with the urn, he's gonna be fine on Antimage just farming up again. And they got nothing with that buyback. They bought back with Visage. Sure, you held your racks, but the tier 3 tower died. You lost 2 heroes. You forced the buyback. CIS are in a great spot now to just claim this game. And Black has so much gold as well. As soon as this Aegis is gone, he's gonna add up whatever item he wants. And I would imagine that a butterfly would be really good in this game. Just to have evasion against Spectre and be able to man fight even harder.
Yeah.
And as we said, they're pretty right-click heavy. That said, though, it's always pretty nice to add up Abyssal Blade if you want to.
Yeah, DT, though, I mean, you can feel that they're under pressure.
Oh, they are.
They had a good situation for that fight just now. Then they had the vision from the Night Stalker with the Aghanims. They had the gem. They saw Inflame sitting on the high ground, ready to go. And they had the element of surprise that CIS thought they didn't have.
Yeah.
They couldn't take a fight off that one. It's really tricky for them now to try and still find a right fight for them where they can catch CIS off guard.
They had a vision, but the positioning they were on was really hard, because when you walk up that ramp, you get so clustered together, and it's just very hard to take a fight from there, especially when you fight up against AA, Sand King, Centaur, hell, even DK, and to an extent even Anti-Mage if he gets a big mana void off. When you stack up this hard against a team like CIS, you can get punished for it.
And they want to still fight though.
Yeah, they swap on Hex
stun,
actually.
Hex, black, action, but black ages, is
two
ages.
Seconds!
Holy crap!
Oh, that
there is still
second.
An 8-second BKB that went, and it looks like DT's like, oh my god, guys, he's coming back, run!
Oh, I'm pretty sure they had a timing on Roshan and tried to do it together with the timing, because there's no way that you want to swap him when he still has the ages. And I mean, they took a timer when Roshan died, and it was just two seconds off.
It was 2 seconds off.
2 seconds later, and this would have been the perfect pickoff.
Oh, that's so sad.
That is really big. So in the end, they get nothing out of this, really. And DT kind of in a sad spot now where they had to back off and just be careful. Of course, using their spells, they can't take a fight after using Vengeful Swap and Hex already. But even this... I like this choice by Dragonite, by the way, going into the Talisman of Evasion. Because as I said, you have...
Do you think he's going to go for Heaven's Halberd with it?
Yeah, it should be a Heaven's Halberd. Because when you have a Spectre in the enemy team who bypasses your armor, you need some extra way to survive against her. And she really just shreds down heroes with high armor with her Desolate and high attack speed.
This was the last Outer Tower on the side of CIS. So it's time to go high ground, which is not an easy thing to do.
They have that vision, at least, from Nightstalker for now.
Oh, swap, stun, where is it? Black still managed to jump himself away, and that's Vengeful Spirit already
gone. That doesn't work.
Looks like they're going to try and chase some people down. June can't really find a stun, though. His BKB is just going to run out, and DT just flees.
Yeah, the coordination was not really there, and they're still not out of this completely safe. Sanking, going to maybe find this Mystics right here.
Ooh, Burrowsack misses, though, and actually... Yeah, the dagger comes in, slowing down slightly. Black getting hexed up still. Can they take him down? No, they can't. He blinks away. He's going to be okay. In July, has got the wall up. Nobody walks through it yet, though. Black.
Sort of low HP on Antmage here. Has to be a little bit careful.
Doesn't really know where to go. Now Manta styles and blinks away again. XDD on the chase, on the hunt. Looks to try and take this down. One more hit. One more hit. Can he do it?
Oh,
no,
wow,
he can't.
That's so close.
That is so damn close. 50 health left. And June going to try to teleport out. We'll be able to make it out in flame, though. Inflame might not be making it out. He's the one to go down. That's going to be a fight that DT took.
The Sand King was completely out of position in this fight. I'm saying this even though he has played really well the entire game. I think the Sand King has been one of the top players in CIS. But in this fight, he just could not get the position at all. He was zoned out down by the bottom rune pretty much and had no chance to help his team. Even though he has a blink and four staff, he was so out of position. So... Not a great start with the missed burst strike, but then he had no chance to get an epicenter as well.
No buyback for the Dragonite.
Oh, this is going to be some damage onto a tier 3 tower at least.
Yeah, oh, if they're indeed only some damage done, maybe they can get June as well. Double Edge comes out, but doesn't really seem
XD,
to hurt
XD. He doesn't
at
take
all.
A lot of damage, though.
Oh, the Veil comes out, though, and there is still an epicenter for the Sand King. So if he can get this right, that would be huge. He's actually channeling up an epicenter right now. Comes in with the Burrow Strike as well, up into XD with that Veil. Oh my god, that is going to be Nightstalker as well as the...
Spectre.
Well, as the Spectre dead, and Anti-Mage, no, he backs off. Black, this ice is not overextend.
Showing off how strong that Veil is right there.
Yes, thank you for proving that item is good.
Yeah, it's really good. It's really cost effective as well on someone like Sand King. He's switching up to Butcher Travels now as well. Keeps that energy booster just to have some extra mana. No real reason to save it or sell it when he has buyback money anyway. And Black is just checking, saw that Roshan is not up just yet. He's going to respawn in just a few seconds here, but they're going to go in for a push instead.
And well, Spectre's dead. They can force out a buyback. She has got a buyback, so that's good for her.
Nightstalker is dead as well, so this is going to be a buyback immediately for Spectre, Radiance, but can they even save this Rax?
Nightstalker does not have a buyback yet, so...
Yeah. Structures are fortified. This is probably going to be Rax.
Black still manages to blink away, and that Vengeful Spirit luckily able to force staff.
Never mind.
That was damn painful. Haunting from Spectre trying to make something happen. The BKBs are there though, and in comes Nightstalker as well with his BKB as well. They want to go for Demons. They will be able to find him. Looking for more, perhaps. They're not going to overextend.
They can't really chase for more, but that four staff. I tried to look over, but who was that actually?
I think it was
the Sand King maybe that four staffed him in
to
the illusion. It has to have been the Sand King because it's the only one on CIS that has one. Either that or his team tried to force staff him and he
suicide force staff.
Yeah, it could have been the team kills force staff. Either way, the illusion of black strong enough to kill a support for sure. And this Roshan here, gonna be attempted by CIS, is not going down that fast, but it's gonna be fast enough, I believe. Look at June just zoning out the enemy team as well.
Yeah, it worked. Can't afford to lose a fight right now, because if they would lose a fight there, they would not only lose the Aegis, but probably also Rax, considering the buyback is on cooldown for a lot.
Yeah, and now, I don't know, it seems that they just want to keep going here and force. They could go for top lane for sure, but seems like they just want to go straight down mid lane. And Black actually sold his Vladimir's already. I think he has a Basher flying in. He does indeed. And Basher, a lot better to have in these fights. Someone else should probably buy a Vladimir's again. It's a useful item to have in this team. But this pressure is really, really dangerous. If they get a pick off on Spectre, then this is pretty much
Look at Inflame baiting out initiation. Burst strike comes out. Whoa, Demon's already hexed up. It's already nuked down as well. We'll be able to get away, though, with the Stampede helping out.
Triple
July,
BKB chasers.
Oh, dead. That's a free fire down for the Vengeful Spirit as well. Inflame doesn't have his BKB anymore. Still has his Aegis. Will be alive again after he dies. They're just going for the Rax. We'll be able to take it down. Nobody dead in the set of CES just yet. And they take down two Rax as well as two heroes. Wow. That's all assumption from the Visage. Still gets the Aegis, but worth it.
Yeah, definitely worth it. And they focused so hard on Spectre there that she couldn't actually turn and fight. She kind of just had to run away.
Yeah.
She also had cooldown, I believe, on the Haunt there. And even if she popped the Haunt, she was low HP. So the illusions would not do that much. But that was really nice execution by CIS. Just seeing the Spectre, jumping her with three heroes, all have BKB and just chase after her, forcing the enemy to run away.
Yeah.
And of course, that way you won't take any damage from dispersion. It is pure damage, but it does not apply if you are BKB form. So BKB is amazing against Spectre, to be honest.
Yeah, Black is the first hero to reach level 25, by the way.
Yeah.
As looking at the levels, this is actually quite scary because we have got, well, the difference is not that big, apart from two heroes from DT not having their level 2 ultimates just yet. But
yeah, it's just the stats as well. I mean, you get a little bit stronger by being level 25 than you are at 20, than you are at 16 as well.
Yeah.
You get quite a bit of stats in that time. So definitely the experience in, like, the experience advantage on CIS is helping them a lot, I think. But at this point, Black is so close to actually just buying up an Abyssal Blade. And when he has that, he can blink in with BKB and initiate on anyone he wants to kill on his own with a Mantis Tile and Abyssal Blade. He doesn't even need to rely on the Sand King and Centaur to follow up on him anymore. And that makes it so much more scary for DT.
And he already was so scary. And the thing is, at this point, I really wish that XCD went for BKB because he's really lacking that. Why doesn't he have a BKB?
It's always tough, like, decision making on what items you should buy on buy on Spectre. BKB is fairly good for fighting, but it does not help your illusions at all. So I can understand why he would not go for it, but he would probably need it in this game because the heroes on CIS are just so strong if you don't. They're like, the Sand King gets full epicenters off with a Veil of Discord. Just the damage from the Centaur is just so much. So I would agree he probably had to buy one in this game.
Yeah, maybe you'll get it instead of his drums.
And there is
soon.
The replacement Vladimir's, second Vladimir's on CIS after Antimage sold his.
Yep.
As
we've
I said,
it's smoke up for CIS as well. I'm looking to try and take the bait that XCD is forming right here.
Yeah, traveling down with demons to bottom lane as well. So, I mean, Dreamtime, they saw that travels. They know this is 5-on-5 scenario. It's going to be a fight. And I don't know if
they
Dreamtime,
wanna
they want to take this fight on their high ground. There's no way they want to take an unfortunate fight out here on the tier 2 and then lose the game.
Radiant's
the best fight you could possibly get is inside
attack.
Your base, close to yourself
Radiant's
when you buy back.
Tower has
but
fallen.
Actually, how many buybacks do they have right now? There's
no
single buyback.
Only
okay, this is miracle time. Time to pull out the massive plays. To be honest, I don't even know which combinations they have, and they're not even going to get a fight because CIS, they're backing off, playing it safe from now.
Yeah, which is kind of surprising. Although, you know, they don't have an Aegis. Maybe they only want to fight with an Aegis, and delaying this game is not working negatively against them, so why not? It's
they
an important game.
They are in control of the entire game, so or entire map, so for sure it shouldn't hurt them too much to wait a little bit if they want to finish up some core item or just wait for travels on Antimage along with buyback. Then you have two Antimages in the fight. Pushing right now, he wouldn't be able to buyback in travels, so there are some things that can still get stronger for CIS for sure. But the thing is that if they pushed, I don't really see how Dreamtime are going to get, like, how they are going to get a miraculous fight. Because normally you look over attack. To a Darkseid and say, hey, someone has to combinate with your vacuum. That's your go-to move in a Darkseid lineup with when you're behind. But then you look to the rest of the heroes. There's Nightstalker, Visage, Spectre, and Venge. Radiant's the only thing they have that could combo with this vacuum is the Visage Bird stun.
Yeah.
That's all. And Visage doesn't even have Aghanim, so you can't even chain stun for a long time. And in the perfect world, maybe they could stun the enemy heroes twice with a vacuum, but that's already so hard to execute, and they wouldn't get that much out of stacking the enemy team up so much. So, I don't know. This is just hard.
Yeah, once again, though, if CIS wins this game, their road to being in the second place after LGD is wide open.
Yeah.
It is such a super important game, not just for CIS, but also for Tong Fu, for Hyper Glory Team, for LGD CDEC, actually, as well.
Yeah. It is an important game overall, and for Dreamtime as well.
Yeah.
They definitely need this win as well, so CIS looking strong, and I don't think they're... Like, they look like they won't make any mistake here. And Black now, during this time that they backed off, he already farmed about 2,000 gold. It goes so fast when you have the entire map to yourself to farm. And he is now able to pick up his travels and a buyback if he wants to. So, available. And Butterfly is completely finished up on Spectre. This
Ruby
is pretty much the last ditch effort here to try and get something going for him. I think they have to take the next fight. Because he does not have buyback, and they're probably going to get forced very soon to defend.
Yeah, and they don't want to give Roshan away, because if CIS gets an Aegis, we've seen what happens. They can take a fight then.
I don't think they will wait, though. This is just them going down on bottom lane and knocking on the door, I think. Because at this point, they know they have buyback on the Antimage who can come back into the fight. Mm-hmm. And they have so many heroes who are hard to kill as well. I reckon they would just go, but we will see. Maybe they just played even more safe.
Could be.
Seems like it, actually.
Yeah, Roshan is going to be up soon. In a minute, we'll know for how long or when he's actually going to be up. But
yeah, the teams, of course, they know that Roshan could be up in 1 minute, and then we'll see. It's just tough to know exactly when. It's not a fixed timer. I like what DT are doing, though. They're not too scared at this point. They farmed up a lot in the enemy jungle. Of course, having Nightstalker with Aghanims gives you good vision, and you can farm up aggressively. Unless the enemy team are smoke ganging you, but... Oh, actually, he didn't go for the travels upgrade and having buyback available. He instead chose to go straight into a 10-second BKB.
New BKB, indeed.
He was on a 4-second BKB, so it's understandable, because 10 seconds, that's a very long time in a late-game teamfight, and we just now hit the hour mark.
Where is that old BKB? I didn't even see it.
I think he just dropped it. Oh, he probably punched it, to be honest. You can destroy your own item, so probably punched.
Swap, Hex, Black, he's in some trouble. He might not even be able to use his own BKB. He's going to try to There you go, BKB is on. He's going to try to turn around. Ghost for XCD, he's already stunned up. Abyssal Blade coming out as well. Do they have enough damage? Burst Strike coming out as well. Yes, they do have enough damage. Holy crap. July trying to run away, surges himself away. It is already the Spectre that's dead, the Venge that's dead. In July is not going to make it out alive by the looks of things either. In comes the Burrow Strike from the side. 3 dead for 0.
Wow.
Initiation coming from DT. That was so close to having Black. If Black actually died there, that would have made a major difference.
Yeah, it would have been big, but they already commit so much and pretty close to... Oh, Io, actually, you're still being chased by a Visage Bird here, but it's going to be fine. But they were fighting so close to CIS base that even if they killed him there, they could probably have bought back and just punished that gank attempt with all the stuns they have. And now there's probably no saving Dreamtime as this push is coming in.
Well, they bought back on the Spectre. They have to win the next fight. CIS is actually ready to actually fight. Is the Burrow Strike in? XCD, first target again. Stampede as well. No stun coming out for him, though. He's going to be able to make it out. Blink away from June as well. The Hex still goes out on Demon, so that's going to be the... Scythe of Ice on cooldown for a while, but CIS is not going to chase.
Yes.
They are actually looking to go maybe for Roshan. It's going to be up in a minute and a half, though.
CIS just don't want to give away a 5-on-5 fight in the enemy base right now, because they know that a 5-on-5 fight is not really what we need. We just got to pick off. We used all our ulties, and there's no reason to take a fight without that. A big thing in that fight as well was Dreamtime's decision. XDD, he used his ulti early in the attempt to kill Black. Mm-hmm. But if he did that, or when he did that, that means he can't buy back and haunt back in. That's something that Vector relies on pretty heavily in late game, is to take a fight, die, buy back, and haunt in. But since he already used a haunt, he was just out of the fight there, and his team got massacred as he died. So very tough scenario. At least to get some D wards here going around the Roche pit. Very important as Roshan is about to respawn. And they have a bird constantly watching as well.
Yeah, this Roshan is going to be important. I actually feel like DT, they can only fight us if they are... if they're 100% sure that they're going to get it, because they cannot afford to lose another fight. It's just not possible.
Yeah, not as they have, you know, already used their buyback now on the Spectre, and she has no gold at all. No. She's like completely starved for money now, and there's no way that she's going to add on a next item before the next fight. It's just not going to happen, and she also won't have buyback, so...
They're going to actually... DT is smoking up four man. They're going to go trying to go for the Roche.
Yeah. They know, and they're going to try to get Black here maybe, but it's not a good pick because he can buy back. They know they want to get one of the disablers like Sand King or even AA. It's a decent pick, but
yeah,
it's a tough scenario to initiate up.
In this scenario, it's really that this Night Stalker is really paying off in nighttime when they're Roshan, because he can see CIS cannot see him.
They saw Roshan now. They have to make their way over there. If they give away this Roshan, this game is over. So just going to try their best and take a fight here. They don't have a choice.
Yeah, they're gonna go in for June first, hexing him up, stunning him as well. In comes Black though. Where's that BKB? Not there just yet. Dreamy backing off. BKB turned on by June, goes for in July. It gets stunned up right as he tries to surge away. As Black is going on XDD. XDD, the Veil comes out as well. Where is the Abyssal? There it is. Malavoid with the Veil. Down he goes. Double kill already for Black. Looking for a triple kill as he's also going to be able to kill off that last one. Actually, only
they didn't lose a single hero in that engagement. So CIS, they just had superior positioning and they had all the items experience to do it. GG gets called. And DT, they did their best.
Denied of the ages.
Yeah, denial of the ages.
Giver of items.
Some nice rares being given out there.
Yo. Oh, I can't believe, like... Ah, the Veil for the Mana Void. It's so strong.
It was a lot of damage. And even a hero like Spectre, who's not an int hero by any means,
he'll
has
still die from
enough
it.
Stats when you're in late game. Sure, she has like Manta Style and Diffusal Blade. Some of it adds up your intelligence. But you're looking at more than 1,000 or more than 1,000 mana. Mana Voiding that with Veil is a lot of damage.
Yeah. This means actually a lot. This means that for CIS, they are going to be able to still make it to the top two. Dreamtime can still make it to the top two as well. But they have a tougher road because they have only one more opponent in this tournament, and that is LGD.
So that is
good luck with that one.
Tough game. Tough game incoming.
Indeed. The next game here, by the way, is going to be Orenda versus New Element. For New Element and for Orenda, both, it's not going to be very important. They are only going to be able to make it to the top four if there's some... upset's going to be happening, if there are some teams going to be losing some unexpected games. For now, actually, for the standings, we're seeing that TongFu, CIS, LGD, CDEC, and Dreamtime, all those teams are on three losses.
Yeah.
And I'm counting losses because that's just easier, because at this point, that is the second least amount of losses that people have. LGD is the highest one up and can also only be number, like, their highest amount of losses is two. So they're going to be number one, guaranteed, set in stone.
For sure.
Number two, number three, number four, number five, open.
Yes.
Wide open.
Pretty much how it goes. So more games coming up, guys. Meanwhile, you can see us on the couch stream up there. Just going to go up and take it easy. Not sure who's going to cast the next game, but yeah, more games coming up, guys.
Yeah, stick around. Bye-bye.